On today's episode of Star Wars Battle Breakdown, we take a look at one of Thrawn's most impressive victories. In 27 BBY, the Republic launched the Outbound Flight, a colony and exploration ship meant to chart the unknown regions and then travel outside the galaxy. The Outbound Flight was largely a Jedi project and was crewed by 18 Jedi, including 6 Masters. Seeing this as an opportunity to weaken the Order, then Chancellor Palpatine, under the guise of Darth Sidious, ordered his lackeys and the Trade Federation to destroy the ship. This brought the Federation into the unknown regions and, more specifically, into Chiss space. Today, we'll discuss the ensuing battle, which is from one of my top 5 favorite Star Wars Legends books, The Outbound Flight. Now, I highly recommend that you guys experience this without spoilers, so if you want to read or listen to The Outbound Flight, click away now. I personally highly recommend the Audible version, which is fully voiced with sound effects, music, and great narration. The book is available on Audible. You can get a 1-month trial and the book for free by going to audible.com/Eckhart's Ladder. Also, full disclosure, I do get money for every person who signs up, but if you want to support the channel, that's a way to do so basically for free. Everyone else, let's continue with the battle. So, the very sizable fleet, made up of 2 Lucrehulk battleships, 6 hardcell transports, and 7 cruisers, were detected by a Chiss patrol, led by military commander Thrawn. The Chiss patrol was quite small, with only 3 tiny cruisers and 9 fighters. After failed negotiations, the Trade Federation opened hostilities by launching half of one of the Lucrehulk's fighters. The other 3/4 of the droid starfighters were kept in reserve due to both the short operating range of the droids and the underwhelming nature of the Chiss fleet, with perhaps the thought that more ships would be coming. One portion of the fighters was sent forward to engage the Chiss fleet, while the others remained behind in a defensive screening position. Thrawn moved his fleet back, guessing the operational range of the fighters, while also sending one of his own cruisers, armed with an interdictor generator, to sit away from the rest of his assets. He found the point where the droid fighters could not move forward anymore without losing signal from the control ships, and conducted an experiment. Thrawn had one cruiser and one fighter move briefly into the operational range of the starfighters, then quickly retreat. He did this over and over again, much to the confusion of the Trade Federation leadership. Each time, the starfighters would begin to engage the Chiss, which would then pull back, at which point the starfighters would return to their initial position. Kinmin Doriana, aide to Palpatine, on board one of the Trade Federation warships, actually believes that Thrawn is attempting to block the communications between the starfighters and the Trade Federation battlecruisers. However, the Trade Federation leadership replied that their encryption software was extremely advanced. Notably, however, he also reveals that should any starfighter be jammed for more than 2 minutes, it will fully self-destruct. Eventually, once this maneuver has been done several times, Thrawn pushes towards the attacking starfighters. The Trade Federation believes that Mithra Nerodo has made a mistake in order the fighters to attack, but there's no response. Now, this is somewhat complicated, but Thrawn had discovered that because of so many fighters, the Lucrehulks were only to use limited encryption signatures. By forcing the droids to perform the same action over and over again, Thrawn was able to dissect the signal, identifying the encryption portion and the command portion. The Chiss responded by sending a counter command, which ordered all fighters to fly off aimlessly into deep space. However, that trick would only work once, and at this point, Thrawn was moving forward towards the ships in defensive position. As the screening ships moved to engage, every cruiser and fighter launched Connor Nets, a missile-based shock net system which outright disabled many of the droids, caused some others to crash into each other, and basically made the force small enough that the fighters and cruisers could take care of them without any losses. The Trade Federation leadership, now furious, orders that the other half of fighters which were being held in reserve by the first battlecruiser be launched. Immediately, before all fighters are able to exit the cruiser, Thrawn begins full spectrum jamming. Now, full spectrum jamming blocks all communication. Generally, it's not very useful against the Trade Federation because they spread their starfighters out, and the jamming can only be done in a small area. However, because Thrawn is close enough to the Lucrehulk, and all fighters are launching from the same point and thus within the same area, he's successful, and the ships are disabled. The starfighters easily mop up the useless ships, with the dust and debris debris caused by many explosions, causing the secondary laser control systems used by the Trade Federation to fail. The Hartzell cruisers then engaged the nearby Chiss fighters. However, through some fancy piloting and the very smart use of Connor nets, the munitions are disabled, not only allowing the fighters to pull away, but also causing the missiles to collide with the ships that fired them. What's more, Thrawn had identified the same weak spot as Anakin in Attack of the Clones, and the missiles were disabled such that they hit that spot, causing the hard cells to go down with a single strike. Thrawn destroyed the rest of the hard cells in a similar fashion and mopped up the smaller escort cruisers. At this point, the Trade Federation fleet is ready to retreat, but is unable to, as the interdiction technology on the Chiss ship was preventing an escape. It had also now been several minutes since the droid starfighters lost communication with their carriers and were now starting to explode. The first Lucre Hulk, which had been in the process of launching fighters when the jamming began, was filled with many partially activated ships, which self-destructed, destroying the cruiser from the inside. The second cruiser hadn't yet launched its fighters, so it was spared, but Thrawn now had it completely surrounded. Thrawn accepts the surrender of the Trade Federation, boarding the ship to discuss their incursion into Chiss space. So, this is obviously an impressive victory. Thrawn destroys an entire task force without losing even a single fighter. What's more, the Chiss didn't even really use droids, so Thrawn was relying on the expertise of George Cardass when trying to figure out how the starfighters would work. It's also impressive because Thrawn comes up with several unique strategies which he only uses one time, constantly keeping his enemies confused and on their heels. But that's just my thoughts. Do you buy this victory? Do you think that full spectrum jamming makes any sense? Are you interested in the Chiss, and would you like to hear more about Thrawn's many victories? Let me know all of that and more down in the comment section, as well as any ideas you guys have for future videos. Also, I put a poll up today looking for some input from you guys, and it's pretty clear that you guys would like to see the Battle of Umbara. I will get to it eventually, I just need to rewatch the Clone Wars arc. Anyway guys, thanks for watching. As always, this has been Eckhart's Ladder. May the Force be with you.